of our community in everybody else's hands but our own. We have put it in the city officials' hand. We have put it into county council's hand. We have put it into the government's hand. We have put it into the police department's hand. We have put it into the school's hand. But never have we put our community in our own hands. We are the ones that wake up every day living in our community. Not President Obama, we love him, yes and true, but he doesn't wake up in our neighborhoods. Not our school teachers, as we love them and give them their honor and respect, but they don't wake up in our communities, but we do. And so it is up to us to take the responsibility of our own communities. No longer are we dependent on the police department to come and get our crime out of our community, but that's our job as neighbors, that's what we do. And so we'll keep our fingers by the telephone waiting and praying as though we protect our communities, because we are the community. We are the neighborhood, and it's time for us to stand up. Stop letting excuses get in our way. Stop letting people hinder us or tell us that we're not good enough. But we are those who are obligated to take care of our communities. I remember a long time ago when we had responsible neighbors. Neighbors who we didn't call nosy, but neighbors who were concerned about what was going on in our community. And so Jesus employs us to all be concerned about our neighbors. Would you go to sleep at night knowing that my son or my daughter is in danger? Or would you be a good neighbor and help me protect my neighborhood? There's no such thing as bad kids, only bad neighbors and bad parenting skills. But when we begin to put our thoughts together, when we begin to unify our communities and stop using excuses about what we don't have, but look at what we do have. And what we do have is each other. We have love. We have support. All we have to do is open up our mouths and be accountable for our community.
Amen.
So I dare you to be accountable for your community. Regardless if they say you're a snitch or not, we don't even care, because they're not living in our community. It is our obligation and our jobs to protect one another. No longer should we lie, should we sit back and lack luster. No longer should we sit back and be lazy and wait for somebody to come rescue us. So even if the government does not give us our park and recreation, what will we do? We will create games in our neighborhoods, like duck, duck, goose, like we used to play. Red light, green light. Y'all ain't saying nothing to me today. Because we're a community. We don't look at what we don't have, but we look at what we do have. And what we do have is strength in numbers. And so let us take back our communities together. For together we stand.
Amen.
Divided we fall. But as long as we live, you are my neighbor, and I'll look out for you and give you all of the love and support that we need. So look around the room. Look at the kids. These are our future. They need us in the community to be strong. Maybe I'm moving. They need us in the community to stand firm. And so we shall do our job as neighbors and take our rightful place in our communities. Thank you very much. Woo!